My name is Connie.
I'm Ian Olson.
My name is Louisa Fields.
I'm Susan Hogue, and I'm mom.
I'm Paul Hogue, and I'm the patient.
My name's Araceli Lopez, and my dad is Richard Lopez, and he has epilepsy.
And I've had epilepsy since I was 13, which makes it 29 years.
The first seizure I had was when I was 60, I mean almost exactly when I turned 60. And I thought, what the heck is this? It was a feeling. It was a feeling of dread.
You see your child go into a seizure and there's really nothing you can do except try to comfort them, try to cushion their head when they've fallen to the floor.
The fear of when one's gonna come on, am I gonna be in danger? There's been times where I've been picked up off of the train tracks here at San Jose.
I could go, a day with multiple seizures in a day, and I wouldn't remember that day at all.
Well, everyone kind of looks at you different when they know you have it. If they don't know you have epilepsy, they can't tell.
When I was small, I didn't really know what epilepsy was, so when he used to have seizures, I knew it was bad, but I didn't really think much of it. But as I got older, I started realizing that, he was in pain and stuff, so.
Since age 11, it took 10 years to get a correct diagnosis.
Really nothing was working. I went through about 9 medications.
He was maxed on 2 different meds and was just sleeping most of the day and night, so he really didn't have a life.
Some of us are on so much medication that the pharmacist sometimes question, hey, why are we dispensing this much,
And I had heard about the NeuroPace probably a good year before that.
We were like, gotta try it, we've done everything else.
I realized that this really is what we needed for our future and for our family. So February, he had the surgery.
First thought of brain surgery puts everyone into a panic. But I mean, in a couple days, I was up around with the kids.
This is something that like nothing else, lets people see what's happening, when it's happening, how long it's happening.
So that the device is trained to actually recognize the very onset of the seizure and send the electrical stimulation. So it's so quick that there are so many times when he has seizures, we don't even know that he's having them.
It's just a lot more relieving being able to see that doctors can see where it is, when it's happening, and do something about it.
I went at least 3 months without a seizure, which is the longest I had gone before since I started having seizures at 11, and I'm 27 now, so in those 16 years, that's the longest that I've been without a seizure.
He doesn't have to take as much medication, and the seizure control is so much better with the RNS. He has much more clarity in thought. He was able to go to Cabrillo College in Aptos, which is a junior college.
And so I'll just spend a lot more time doing the kinds of things I want to instead of being hit with, oh man, I hope I don't have a seizure night that day.
I see an improvement in every single day, and I'm grateful that I don't have to witness those seizures as much anymore, because that was really difficult for me as his wife to see that.
Well, I feel safer. I feel a lot more safer that my doctors can see what I'm describing to them.
I can do soccer. I can ski, I can do volleyball.
I'm all for looking for ways to improve my life, so I would recommend it to anyone else.
We don't worry as much that my dad's gonna have a seizure.
The doctors looked at the data on it and said, hey, you had a seizure this day, what were you doing? I was at my desk plugging away. So at that point, when they told me that, I think I sat in the car for a little bit and had a cry. Thought that would have been it right there.
What you see in 6 months could be a big change, but 2 years from now, it could be an even bigger change.